We now have a nod from the UK regulatory authority to also expand this study in United Kingdom. So we are building a global footprint. Basal cell carcinoma is not just an American problem, it's a global problem.
Hey, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Dr. Raza Bokhari. He is the CEO of Medicus Pharma. And Dr. Bokhari, nice to see you again. How are you?
I'm doing really well, Steve. Thank you for having me back on your program.
Yeah, so the company out with some news today talking about gaining UK approval to expand your phase two trial in dealing, obviously, with non-invasive treatment of basal cell carcinoma of the skin. So maybe you could sort of remind everyone a little bit about what's going on in the UK and what this expansion really means.
Steve, really appreciate this opportunity to provide an update. We continue to pick up momentum and move forward in our clinical development program of our lead asset, SkinJet, which is a novel non-invasive treatment for non-melanoma skin diseases, particularly basal cell carcinoma of the skin. We have been had initiated our phase two study back in the summer of 2024 in 9 sites across the United States, in 90 patient study. We have been expanding the global footprint of our study with a separate study of 36 patients that earlier in the summer of this year commenced recruiting patients in the Middle East with Cleveland Clinic, Abu Dhabi. And pre-market today, we also announced that we now have a nod from the UK regulatory authority to also expand this study in United Kingdom. So we are building a global footprint. Basal cell carcinoma is not just an American problem. It's a global problem. Wherever there is sun, ultraviolet radiation, and exposed skin surface, that's a breeding ground. So we believe that our work is getting recognized by the regulatory bodies, and I hope that we are very bullish that we will have positive findings, and we will move into a pivotal study.
What does it mean when you talk about expansion of the study in the UK? Will that just mean more patients or more sites, or is it a combination of both?
So it is actually a little bit more efficient. So with respect to UK, our existing study, which is the SkinJet 003 study, which is an FDA-approved study and is being carried out in 9 sites in the United States, we actually can just, we have added an additional site, or could be more than one site, but at least one site, which would add patients to that 90 patient study. So it is a more cost effective and an efficient way to bring in a patient pool from different relevant geographic locations, without starting a brand new study, which we had to do in the Middle East, where we had to add 36 more patients. So this is, in some ways, as we are advancing forward, we are also becoming, utilizing our experience to make the clinical study more efficient and cost effective.
And that's what I was going to ask you next, this ability to do this and what you've learned in other markets as well has been able for you to utilize this in the most cost-effective way. And that's really important in the development of what you're trying to do.
It is indeed very important. We are setting the stage on the heels of a Type C meeting that we completed with the FDA towards the end of the third quarter, where we have a pathway to registration very clear to us. We are getting ready to sit in an end of phase two meeting in Q1 of next year, where we are very confident that we will qualify for a fast track designation, which will give some clarity on the pivotal design and setting this groundwork in the Middle East, in U.K., and already that exists in the United States would go a long way in having a robust pivotal study design and also executing on that pivotal study. So this is couldn't be more positive for the future outlook of the company.
Dr. Bokhari, thank you so much for giving us a quick update on what's going on this approval as well, and really appreciate your time.
Thank you so much, Steve, for having me back on your program.
Dr. Raza Bokhari, the CEO of Medicus Pharma.